the biggest gang investigation in the history of Georgia, a southern state, yielded over 80 indictments, 77 of them white supremacists. They are called the Ghostface Gangsters, okay? Now, they are reluctant to call them white supremacist gangs. They keep using terminology like gangsters and street gang. However, these are white supremacists, and this is in fact a white supremacist gang. Here are their pictures. You see them? Take a good look at them. This is the single largest gang investigation in Georgia. That's how local and state officials are describing Operation Kibosh, led by Richmond County Sheriff's Office against Ghostface Gangsters, criminal street gang. Police say 77 of them are part of the Ghostface Gangsters. It's one of the fastest growing gangs in the country, made up of mostly white supremacists. The crimes range from attempted murder, drug trafficking, to aggravated assault to an officer. Now, who led that investigation? This guy, the sheriff of Richmond County, Sheriff Richard Roundtree. Now, let me take you back to something quite interesting. Because when you look up this story, you will see a reluctance to show their pictures by many of these publications. They are also not providing their names in many of these publications, talking about the biggest gang investigation in the history of Georgia. And they're not calling them a white supremacist gang, even though they are. Now, let me tell you why it's important to call a thing a thing. If we were talking about the Crips, they would tell you this is the Crips gang. If we were talking about Piru Bloods, they would tell you this is about Piru Bloods and it is the street gang. If this was about Gangster Disciples, they would tell you this is about Gangster Disciples. They will provide context. Here's the context here. These are white supremacists. That's an important context, white supremacist. So while many would like you to believe that the face of gangster life or the face of gangster violence and gangster activity is only relegated to those with black and brown skin, let's be very clear. The most notorious gang ever in the United States of America has always been and will forever be the KKK. That's a gang too. So here's what we decided to do on Indisputable. Since a lot of these publications have been reluctant to tell you exactly who they are and to show you their face and their name, we got a little something for you. Here it is. You will notice that some of them look quite normal and some of them do not. You will also notice a lot of females who are part of this gang. A lot of young females are members of this white supremacist gang. Now, obviously, they have been charged. All of this is alleged until conviction. But wow, look at the number of white females who are members of this white supremacist gang. Now, I had a conversation with another gang expert about this because I notice when there's a big gang bust of a black street gang, you don't see as many women as you do in this bust. And he said something quite interesting to me. He said for them, this is very generational, that the gang activity is extremely generational. And they need women, they need these particular gang members to raise the children into the ideology. And what you see as a difference with a lot of the black street gangs in particular is that they work very hard to isolate their children from that same life. They try very hard to make sure that their children do not experience that same journey. Not so in many of these white supremacist gang. They see it as a generational connection. The investigation yielded indictments against 77 gang members. This investigation was initiated based on the gang's affiliation with high levels of drug distribution and violent crimes. Sheriff Richard Roundtree said, at a news conference Friday announcing the arrest and indictments. We know that attacking criminal organizations at the core is the most effective way to remove lawless street gang members from our society and have the greatest impact on gang prosecution. Once again, they're not saying white supremacist. I'm providing the context for you. The gang is involved in criminal cases throughout Georgia, South Carolina, and Tennessee, and deep into the Georgia Department of Corrections, according to the sheriff's office. The Ghostface Gangsters are trying to expand into neighboring states and are considered the fastest growing white gang in the country. JR, how do you see this, brother?
Well, I mean, I guess it goes along with what we've always seen. And as you pointed out in so many different ways here, we talk about how the context is how they're pointing out who these folks are and really where they came from and how little reporting there really is around that. Names, faces, pointing out who they really are and where their ideology comes from. Now, there's reason for that. It's because everyone gets brainwashed. And I'm talking across the board in the country. Black folks will generally may think, oh my God, these black gangs, they're everywhere. Oh my God, look, the Crips and the Bloods, like we hear about the name and it's supposed to incite fear. We live in LA, and if as the gentrification of different parts of the city come, there's people that are, they say it to my face. You know, I got friends that when I lived in Inglewood, they would come over, this is 2007, they'd come over and be like, are you sure? Are you sure? Because there's this automatic thing in the back of people's heads that, oh my God, I'm in an area where people that I think are afraid, are scary live. But as they come in to move, it's suddenly not as scary because you're taking over the area, taking over resources and really coming into your own knowledge, your neighborhood. So it's a lot less threatening. It's the same neighborhood you were afraid of before. Now, only reason I bring that up is because the reporting for things like this, it just goes across the board that, oh, these are just white folks that are trying to do something. Maybe they're patriots, they're trying to defend their country. They're afraid of what's happening in our country, which then as you see, things like the indoctrination of their children, the number of women that are involved in this. The basis behind these gangs is more of, let's teach our kids our values. Our values of racism that have been carried throughout the country. When it comes to a lot of black gangs, it's survival that these began. Because of the oppression, because of the situations they're put in different neighborhoods. And then many kids felt, oh, I need some kind of protection. Oh my God, I need to join this situation or this group. And whatever comes with that, the illegal things that come with that just comes with it because what are my other options? There are options for these folks. Yeah. These folks, they chose this route when they could have had another option. That's the difference you'll see a lot of times with these folks. Now, I'm sorry, I've rambled for a while, but there's a couple of thoughts I also had still. The largest terror organizations in the country have been deemed by the Department of Justice and law enforcement agencies are these white supremacist terrorist groups. It's where they've been for the past several years, if not forever. It's just we decided to say it for real now. But if we report it as such every time, it might actually permeate a couple of people's brains for them to realize what the situation is here. It's why you have Donald Trump, when he was in office, can walk up and say, oh, Charlottesville, there's good people on both sides. He can say that because he knows there's enough people that have been brainwashed to believe it. And he doesn't have to take any political hit over it because that was his base.
Wow, very well said, man. Great points. And I will say this to one of the points you made. As a teenager, man, I was a foster child. I was also in a gang. I was a gangster disciple. I've been a gang deprogrammer for years. I went around the country, continue to do that work. Over 90% of the time, when somebody calls me to say, I need you to help these young people, I need your deprogramming expertise, it's the parents. It's the parents who are calling. And yeah, some of those parents were caught up in gang life themselves. So you don't see the generational connection. They're trying to disconnect from that sort of life because they were part of those gangs and gangs affected or gang affiliated because of necessity and atmosphere conditions, etc. These individuals are utilizing it obviously as a pretext to commit violence against those who do not think nor look like them. It's quite fascinating that right now, the story that we're talking about, it is still really not national news. And it is one of the largest gang bust in the history of America and the largest in the history of the state of Georgia.
You would think this is something that we're supposed to celebrate, because when law enforcement does their job, we celebrate it, right? Oh my God, they got the bad guys. Maybe fewer people will be affected. Now, what makes people so scared of street gangs? Things like marijuana distribution, drug possession, drug dealing, aggravated assault, murder, attempted murder, trafficking of folks. I'm just reading from the list of the things that this gang is doing. Just to point that out. Those several things that I just read, by the way, this laundry list, I can't read it all. I just read five or six of them.
Yep.
It's on the list of the things that they're being charged with. Yep. So why aren't we afraid of them the same way? Just ask yourself that question. If you see these guys walking down the street, we're gonna get to drug dealing stories later in this in this story. Fake drug dealing stories, what people are afraid of happening in the neighborhoods. Are you afraid of them doing it? Of all these people that we just showed pictures of? If you see them leaning into a car and maybe sticking something in their pocket, are you running up on them?
Yeah.